The work in H2O utilizes a process that Madzoeff developed using music as a vibrational influence on poured paint. The concept is based on the theory in Masaru Emoto's book, The Hidden Messages in Water. Emoto believes that water is physically influenced when exposed to vibrations. Madzoeff process takes this concept and uses the vibration of music to influence her paintings, which are created by pouring liquid acrylic onto polyester film. During the process, a chosen song is played on repeat in the presence of the painting, allowing the musical vibration to affect the painting throughout the drying process, which can sometimes take up to 2 days. Each painting is made of several pieces created from the same song. The chosen song becomes a backbone that the finished pieces are built on, allowing Madzoeff to work within a structure but still maintain the opportunity for intuitive decisions. Music used for the paintings in this exhibition included tracks from Nina Simone, Little Dragon, CLMD, Blood Orange, and Smashing Pumpkins. Also on view are recent works by Quinton Bemiller, Anita Bunn, and Mark Stephen Greenfield. Quinton Bemiller continues his exploration of color and space with the eye-popping red against blue, as well as in several smaller paintings. Anita Bunn's grid of 9 continuous tone lithographs were printed in collaboration with master printer Francesco Siqueiros of El Nopal Press. Bunn experiments further with color in a suite of lithographic monoprints. Mark Stephen Greenfield's large ink on Duralar piece, I Sing the Body Techneric, is based on his experience of a local religion during a residency in Brazil last summer. The hand-painted nesting dolls of the Pushkin Paradox, as well as the large drawing Duke the Crow, reflect further on Greenfield's investigation of racial stereotypes.